Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Heart Party. Here's your host, Cinnamon Cooney.
How are you guys doing today? I am... headdress. It's been a journey getting here. There has been some stuff getting to this episode. This hat, dude, check it out, was created by Margarita, whom has been on the show helping us out before. This is her talent, and she loaned me her apron, so see... it's a whole thing. And apparently I'm not mic'd correctly. I'm mic'd wrong. But a mysterious mic fairy is gonna come and fix my mic live. Isn't that the magic alive? So if you guys were not already clear, because I've had the rescheduling, we're doing Mark's Garden, which is this fabulous skull and roses. I think I have the link to his photograph in the description. If I don't, I'll get it there after the live broadcast, so you can print that out and look at that, or Mark can post it up in the comments, and that way if you guys want to print out the photograph that this came from, you can. Of course, I will ask our fabulous Chuck Carson to do a traceable, because drawing should not be the barrier to painting. And today we're going to do something a little crazy. We're going to do something a little different. Not that I like to do that to you guys all the time, but we're gonna do one of these gallery wrap square canvases from Michaels, which they often have on sale. They say this is a professional level 3 canvas. I don't really know where they get this grading, because here's what. I like the wrap on this. It generally has a good drum. I really haven't drilled down deep on the square of these canvases. If you're ever having to frame, you wanna check the square. Ooh, there's the chemical pre-gessoed smell you love so much. I'm gonna throw my trash over here irresponsibly. So here's my issue with these canvases. Can you see this right here?
Yeah, we can see that.
Yeah, so really, this should be folded and stapled, but they cut it. Which means, I don't know that professionally, I would necessarily feel good about sending that out into the world. Would I just, in my personal life, paint on it and enjoy it and say that's a really well-priced, gallery-wrapped, deep-edge canvas? Sure. If professionally I was going to sell it, I would get a deep-edge from Frederick's, or I'd get one actually called the edge from Jerry's. Because I have a real problem with that as a finish, though the back is really nice. So that's what we're painting with today, with this fabulous headdress. We have the paint, which we'll tell you about in a minute. And of course, I hide the materials in the description, to hide things in the description. What's going on in the group today?
Oh gosh, we have so many people up there saying hello to us today.
Do we?
Oh my gosh, there's Amy, Pete, Esther, Michelle, of course, you know, our moderators, Mona, and I think that, Mark Muir. Muir is here for sure. Kim Sim is helping out.
I don't know how to show everyone what I'm sippy sippy today.
Oh, yeah. You'll show your sippy sippy. That's right. You got a cool mug, didn't you?
I did.
That's an awesome mug.
Look at this amazing, amazing mug. Now, I'm sorry. I know I should be teaching a lesson, but I got to share the story of this mug with you. So I'm at the Michaels, like you are, looking for things for my wonderful episode today. And I was actually kind of hunting for just anything fun I ran into. And then at this end cap, I see... a whole end cap of the Crafty Chica. And I just start to lose my mind. I'm like, oh, I'm pointing, I'm going, I kind of know her on YouTube. I kind of know her on YouTube. So Kathy is actually a member of the Creative Arts Collaboration. And I have been made aware of her by other members who are like, you've got to check her out. And I did, and I was like, this lady has her kit together. Oh my goodness. I'm so inspired by her. She actually friended me on Facebook, which was so exciting for me. It really was.
It's that's like awesome.
When other really great YouTubers talk to you, like when Lindsay the Frugal Crafter talked to me, I literally had a bag over my face, like breathing in and out of bag. I was so excited. You'd have thought like the Beatles had showed up at my house. So it was kind of like that. And I really admire Kathy, but I have to tell you, as a YouTuber, seeing her take her designs and her art and seeing it at Michael's was, I don't know, it was, John will tell you, I was freaking out excited.
Yeah, it was really funny.
I'm gonna show this
really
to you again.
About it. And everybody out here on the channel loves it too.
Is this not gorgeous?
And Marisha thinks this looks really cool too.
This is, I kind of like, I wasn't gonna tell y'all she has an Etsy store where she has some handmade stuff too. Cause I want to get a piece before she gets too big to even buy something from. And then in this cup, because I was like, well, what can I put in there special? And I found this at the World Market.
Oh, yeah.
And I can't decide if I find this offensive or not.
Mexicoco?
The Mexicoco. I'm like,
It's cool. Mexicoco.
Yeah, I don't, but it is tasty.
Yeah.
So I can is it nutritionally sound?
It's yummy.
Not a healthy. It's yummy.
It's delicious.
It's sippy sippy, but it's not a healthy life choice. But I thought that that was the, I wanted something like, it's got a little chile in the cocoa.
Ah.
Ooh. So that's, all right, that's what it was. I'm sorry, just chatting. I don't know what y'all think of that, but I was excited to see her stuff. And then Margaret bought a game. Margaret was looking for a game for her daughter's. That's my phone now.
There's a phone.
Isn't that alarming? See, this is why I do blame the bus driver that we're late today, because I have these alarms that go off that tell us when to go be there, and we listen to them. Innocent bus driver, not. I love bus drivers everywhere.
Yeah, that thing quiet on the set, not here.
Mm-mm. No, so excited about that, kind of freaking out. Oh, I had to also share what I found.
Oh, and yeah,
I don't
yeah.
know why I'm
Show
sharing
those.
This with you. I don't get paid for this, but sometimes you find things. Seen this? Are you freaking out? Because I
Those
was freaking
are adorable.
Out. I was like, look, and of course I have kids, so I had to get three. So I got all three. I wasn't buying all three for you guys, even though you guys are so sweet. I have three children. You can't give. You can't say this is everyone's, because then they'll go Game of Thrones and fight each other for it. Oh, here's her branding.
Ooh.
Ooh. Right?
That's really cool.
Is that so real, isn't it?
Yeah.
I was like, go Kathy. Go Kathy. Go Kathy. You did really cool. All right. Sorry. Palette cam. Mm-hmm.
Oh, palette cam. Okay.
Yeah. Hi,
we're
everybody.
Going for,
I know
for
I'm
real.
Going bananas. It's a bananas day. All right. So, look, I did it correct today. Titanium white, cad yellow medium, dioxazine purple, phthalo blue, cad red, yellow ochre, burnt sienna, and Mars black. May not or get into the Mars black today. If I do, it'll be like towards the end.
Just a little bit, maybe.
Question you might have.
What's the question?
Do they have the question if they can do this on a 16 by 20 or other canvas and how they would do that?
I think that no one has asked that question.
Okay.
I'm sure it's a question that they would like to know the answer to.
So what I want you to do is, if you're painting a 16 by 20, lay it out as a horizontal and focus this on the right-hand side, what we're painting, and then just carry our background out across your whole canvas.
Okay.
That's what we're going to do. Guess what else I'm going to teach you how to do?
What else?
Traceables. All right.
Now the traceables.
So, I'm always telling you guys, you can just trace that on and that'll be so easy. But then it occurred to me, maybe somebody wasn't sure how to transfer an image onto their canvas. And then they're like, do I get graphite paper? What do I do? And it's a whole big horrible question in the art store. No, you don't. You know that chalk I'm always making you get? So when you print out one of our coloring pages that you're going to use for a traceable, or if you're going to hopefully, hey guys, give, you know, if you've got little brushes with you, you can give these coloring pages to your kids. But when you print them out, you're going to take your colored chalk and you're going to just color the back of it. I freehanded this on, but that's what you're going to do. And you're going to use the artist tape, which I told you guys about, which is this yellow tape. It's like $1, $2 at Michael's and worth getting, because you can put it onto any surface and then you can trace on there. So I'm going to tape this down. Taping your tracing paper down is super important.
Yes. Keeps it in place.
It keeps it in place and it won't move on you and make you crazy. And I'm just gonna quick show you how well this works. Okay, so you could do this with Chuck, and he's gonna give you a lot more digital information because Chuck is a sweetheart like that and wants you guys to have the best experience possible. All right, that's what he wants. So he's definitely gonna try to make sure that you guys are having as good of a time as you can. But I don't really need that much information to get this in. And you can kind of see me put this in.
Yeah.
All right, now I'm gonna lift it up. I don't know if you can see it on the up close cam. Did it transfer? It did. So I get a very faint line.
Yeah, it's real hard to see here.
Well, then you know what I'm gonna do?
Can I make it darker?
Mm-hmm.
You're going to disappear off camera.
With because I had put my watercolor pencils on the ground. $5. So now I can tell you guys about these. Watercolor pencils are so nice. I'll sketch it in purple. Why do we like watercolor pencils when we're sketching things in? Because they absolutely vanish into the sketch. Who all is here today?
Oh my gosh, so many people.
Well, I'm sketching this in.
We have over 50 people here.
50 people, and we haven't even known we were going to be here. I'm surprised 50 people hung in with us.
I know, it's just like crazy.
It kind of is amazing, guys. Thank you.
So, Jane is painting on a 12 by 12 canvas, is what she said.
Okay.
And I think that Mark is painting along as well. I know that so is Maricha. She said that she was recording and painting today.
She's recording and painting? Oh, my goodness.
She's committed.
She is. Maricha has a YouTube channel, The Junk and Data Girl. And she's quite an artist. And she's an admin at the Creative Arts Collaboration. And we kind of give her a bunch of grief that she needs to put up more content.
Is there some channel heckling happening?
Bernadette's like, hee. Who's also an admin? She's like, yes. But you too, Bernadette.
Everyone, it's a is that good?
Oh, it's like the hot cocoa. That's so Graveyard Girl, the originator of our Sippy Sippy.
That's right.
She starts with her pumpkin spice lattes, which John knows I used to be an addict.
Yep.
But then I had to stop.
Yep.
Because I was looking like a pumpkin, drinking the pumpkins. So it's getting to be a problem.
They don't tell you they're like 3,000 calories. They're tasty.
I looked it up and it was like something like 4 Coca-Cola's worth of sugar. And I was like, bananas! So now I'm down to this delicious cocoa. But it's my same thing. It's sort of the ring in of the season.
Ooh.
Oh. Okay, gorge, right? Look, this is not a sponsored video by the...
They're just cool.
It's just cool. And she's a fellow YouTuber. And I mean, it's like those big vloggers that do stuff on YouTube. And I think it's nice that they do. But
Yay. This
is personally exciting to me. Personally.
Yay tubers.
Yay tubers. Yay art tubers. Yay art tubers is what it is. So thank you for showing that up close. And I bet, now understand, she and I know each other on a total acquaintance through... this organization. So she's gonna be, if she sees it, she'd be like, this is a very weird girl. It's a very strange girl. So I don't want to be giving you guys like some sort of weird impression that we like all besties.
But we do like the mugs.
But we do really like the mugs, and I thought that was super exciting. I think I'm gonna start out with a half inch angle.
Yep.
Let's do this.
You wanna center up that the palette there?
So we can
just push it forward.
No. I will knock things off.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I can't. We can see all the paint.
Okay, we can see them. We're good.
And so we're going to be okay, because I got to tell you, I kind of laid it out. John lays out the words and then I match them up, and my purple is a little farther from my sienna than I would want you guys to leave your purple in your sienna.
And we can move those. We can change that around.
So now I'm going to lay this in. This background is a very loose, expressive background. Something I want to talk to you guys about, because it's been asked, and I probably need to do this like on a whole special episode. Look at me, I'm gonna paint this edge. I'm gonna carry this painting around the edge. That's the magic of this kind of art right here. If you guys did not know already, is that I have now created a gorgeous gallery look for a very small pocketbook price. And that is absolutely, completely awesome.
Do you want to go ahead and pull the close-up better up over on that one? Just tilt it up.
You changed, honey. You changed the equipment.
This is you should know this one. This is your one you're used to. You unlock it with your thumb. See how much smoother it moves?
Are you trying to stop the nausea effect?
I just thought.
Is this an attempt to control the nausea cam? But that's like our e-ticket ride, right?
Well, I thought I'd put a fluid head down there to make it a little easier to move.
I so appreciate that. Oh, and you guys, I'll put a link to the Crafty Chica's YouTube channel. I don't know. I guess I could do it in my iCard. I could easily do, I'll do a thing, I'll link it up.
We'll get it in there.
We'll get it in there and so you can find it, because you got to see.
Yeah.
You got to see.
Because you two should be art besties.
We are not stalking you, sweetie. It's okay. You're safe. Everything's all right. Mostly all right. You know what? I shouldn't play because you could lose a channel on YouTube.
That's true.
Oh, are we in another one of our good moods?
Well, I think they're always good moods.
I like it. I like it when we're there. I'm adding a little the yellow ochre, but I feel like I want to come and make a little green here.
Make some green?
Uh-huh. Make some green right here. So this is sort of fun for me. I'm creating this deep, and we're going to come back and do this. Oh, so I completely lost my train of thought. Somebody's going to be like, that's so unprofessional.
Yep.
Yep. Anyhow, yeah, because no professionals I know ever lose their train of thought. Yeah. Anywho, some of you have commented on the different ways that we put in the paintings. Like sometimes we do an acrylic colored ground, or sometimes we put in an underpainting, or sometimes we block in tonal values. And you're like, why do you change it up? The reason I change it up is there are many, many, many ways to do a painting. And I want to make sure that as we're traveling along together, that I'm showing you guys many of those ways. I've got some burnt sienna over to my blue. And I'm going to take this here and, ooh, just, I better not get any. This isn't really my, I'm borrowing this apron from my friend Margaret, so it just occurred to me, I better not get any paint on it or I will be back on Etsy looking for a replacement apron. Like you do. Oh, see, that's just gorgeous. So what we're doing is we're creating almost a Baroque background.
Yeah.
It's in the vicinity of that, which just means it's a dark kind of Gothic feeling with a high focal light point. That's basically it. You know, on that one, Google it, because...
So I was just getting some feedback. They were saying
feedback.
Yeah, unfortunately, it was like, turn it up, John.
Oh no!
No, it's okay. Sometimes that happens. We get, audio levels are one of those difficult things to know because you get it.
Was it bad turned down or?
Well, I think it was down just a little bit low, and
Will we be losing viewers over it?
No, I don't think so.
Okay.
But audio is one of those tough things to get balanced.
I think one of our hecklers was heckled us over audio. I think that was one of their big complaints. They were kind of like an early heckler. And I almost kind of let it alone because I was like, yeah, you're right. Yeah,
our audio is kind of
bad. I was just really like, you're right, we suck. Heckle away.
Yeah.
Now, normally you would dry this and not just flip this like I am doing. But I'm flipping it.
What are you
so
doing?
I flipped it wet.
That's okay.
But you don't flip it wet. Don't you do that. Don't you flip it wet.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to get a little burnt sienna in there and I'm just darken this up because I want this to be a very, very dark green over here.
Yeah. That's sort of a very Mark green.
Yes. Mark's got some. He started a mermaid trend on the Heart Party page on Facebook where they're all doing zombie mermaids.
Well, that's great.
Yeah, it's a whole trend. Like, I'm like, did I miss the trend? Should I have done a zombie mermaid painting and I just didn't know it?
I think the answer to that is probably yes.
Yeah, it probably is. But that's okay. Mark caught it. He saved it for us.
Well, he sends some zombie hugs.
Is Mona made it in today? I know she's recovering, too.
Oh, yeah. I think Mona's moderating.
Oh, that's right. Thank you, Mona. Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Maricha. Maricha's probably painting and...
Kim Sims as
Hi,
well.
Hi, Kim. Do we have did Secret or Bernadette make it?
I've not been able to watch real closely to see if their names have flown by.
You miss a lot of stuff,
I
you
do.
Know, in trying to edit and moderate and watch comments.
And do sound.
And do sound. It's a lot of stuff gets lost.
Primarily, I'm watching where you're going for switching cameras.
I know. I'm such a pain. I'm getting back in with my deep purple and darkening this up. I really am. Oh, now I got to paint this whole side. But painting the sides is worth it, I promise. Sigh. Actually, I'm not sure how much this painting being smaller will impact the time on this film.
You know, I don't know. It little less to cover, but I mean, it doesn't seem like it's that much less to cover.
It'll be interesting to observe. Does the smaller canvas? And now I talk like this, and I don't know why. Does the smaller canvas change it?
Does it?
Oh, we should let everybody know. Everybody's okay. Thank you for being patient about us having to be off the air.
Yep. Thank you. I was a little under the weather.
Yeah. Is it okay if I say?
Sure.
John has Crohn's. So that's something that our family deals with from time to time. If you've known anyone who has that, it's a journey. It's a challenging thing, and sometimes your body just betrays you completely.
Just doesn't cooperate with filming schedules.
Or anything, or life. And it's quite painful and scary, and we control it a lot through diet and lifestyle, and
We
work it out, but every once in a while one gets away from us.
Yep.
Nice dark background is happening
oh,
here.
It's oh, it's looking good.
Sippy sippy time.
Sippy sippy.
Before I lose the heat of my cocoa.
The heat of the cocoa. We have a microwave, so we can add more heat.
Yeah, it's really, so the cocoa, I made it with vanilla soy.
Oh.
Which was super yummy, but also makes replenishing the sippy sippy just challenging.
Yeah.
I'm just like, woohoo!
It definitely goes.
Leave me a butter dish and a cup on our Etsy store because I really want to go by and grab one.
Yeah.
It's signed.
It's signed. That's awesome.
I think it's print signed, and I want one that's signed, but I'm not here art begging. Don't worry, Gabby. I'm just going to go by your Etsy store and buy something. That's all I'm going to do. This is all.
Yep. I feel an art stalker coming on.
Sometimes I do. I feel like I'm always worried that other artists are going to be like, is she stalking me? Lindsay's been really patient with me, which has been terrific. She's been so amazing.
I just have to make sure that you know which Lindsay is in when I tell you.
He's like, yeah, we know a lot of Lindsays, and sometimes Lindsay the Frugal Crafter will come in and be like, hey, it's Lindsay. And I'm like, hey, Lindsay.
Yeah.
It happens.
All so right. What brush are you using now?
Still half inch angle brush. I am wiping it off on my towel. And I'm going to come with a little burnt sienna and a little dioxazine purple and a little phthalo blue. And I'm going to make the darkest color I can make. I may even add a little cad red. And I'm dark. Oh, see, now I'm deep, deep. And I'm going to start blocking in some of the shapes on my skull. So this is a really cool painting on Paint My Photo.
Yeah.
Picture. And Margaret and I were there. She'd come over, and I tricked her into a periscope. Like apparently you do your friends, you just trick your friends into a periscope.
Yeah.
And doing very dark colors in these spaces. Right now we're doing kind of a tonal sketch. All right, that's what we're doing here. We're just making sure we've got a really dark tonal sketch going on. And so we were over in painting, and she picked out this picture with the skull and some roses, and we went to go print it out, and I go, oh my gosh, that's Mark's picture.
Oh, wow.
We did not even know. See, I'm mixing colors like your kids mix colors, just trying to get as dark of a color as I can. Very similar to how your kids would mix a color set. Just kind of working that in. And so he'll start very dark. One of the things I like to think about is in acrylics, a lot of times what we're doing is dark and then going up to light, whereas watercolor is about saving the lights.
Yeah.
And building up your darks. Sometimes acrylics, not all the time, because there's a lot of ways to paint acrylics, but sometimes painting acrylics is you're going the opposite direction of watercolors, which is why it can be really frustrating for watercolor painters to make the change, because they're trying to preserve their whites.
Ah.
And I think do we have any lefties in the building today?
I imagine we do. I'll ask. Well, you just asked, so I'll keep an eye out for it.
I've just asked, right?
Yeah.
I'm getting some burnt sienna and some white.
Oh, I was looking over there at the channel to see if anyone's in there.
Ah, I got some burnt sienna and some white, guys, and added it to my blue. I'm going to get in there and lighten it up just a little bit for around the ocular cavity. I still want these all close enough to see the shapes. I want to see the shapes, but I'm valuing up the differences enough so that I can know what my shapes were. Anybody answering about the lefty? I'm adding a little white.
Trying to keep an eye out there.
I think
Mark's a lefty.
Okay, so I've had some people ask me about this, and I'm not, but I painted a long time. And I've been in the studio with lefties, because that's going to be a percentage of the people painting. And there's a lot of myths about that, you know, if you're left-handed, you're a better artist. And I get that, because I think lefties are given a huge amount of grief. So I think they're like, I'm a better artist. But here's the real deal behind
me. You popped your oop. You just knocked it loose. That hurt my ear.
Woo.
Wow. Let's see if we can fix that. Wow. Yeah, you plugged in?
Yeah, am I?
Okay, there we go.
Yeah, okay. So, woo.
All right,
that just went.
Let's get all the audio back in there.
Is it good?
I think we're back.
Here's my lefty soapbox. So, yes, of course, one of the intuitive things is instead of from painting right to left, you can paint from left to right. That's a thing that you can do. And you can do an upward brushstroke sometimes when others are doing a downward brushstroke. All of this, and this is from just a bunch of lefty artists that I have talked to. What they've said is the hardest thing about being a left-handed artist is that you're not just allowed to develop the way a right-handed artist is, to just figure out your stroke and your comfort and where it works for you. People are constantly trying to inhibit that. So the number one thing you need to do when you're left-handed is really listen to yourself and tune other things out and find, the same way when I'm discovering my brushstroke, let yourself rediscover your brushstroke, because often in school, in art school, art instructors will really interfere with that. And by the way, art instructors, please don't do that.
Yeah.
Don't interfere with the development. Every artist has a right to figure out their comfortable stroke. And I don't know. I think less now that education is more educated, they don't tend to. I don't hear as many stories of people having their left-handedness really fought against. But there's a whole bunch of people in my age range and younger that really went through that. So that's your big part of your art journey, is to let that go. And go, now I'm going to figure out my own brushstroke. Thank you very much.
Right.
But of course, left to right is a way to go, and sometimes upwards instead of downwards. But again, if you're allowed to discover that, then you just discover that. Pretty much.
Pretty much.
Now I'm going to come over here with a slightly lighter, it's still pretty dark, kind of bluish gray. And I'm just getting this underpainting of all of this in. So I don't know if that was helpful to anybody, but hopefully that is.
It seems like it was helpful.
I don't know. Sometimes I say something like, I have no idea if any of this is helpful. It's like shouting down a well, isn't it? Like, I don't know. Could be good. Might not be. We're just getting our skull in. You know, getting those layers built up. I think most of our community at this point has fairly embraced that painting is a lot about building up the layers. So I've come around with a dark color and this undershadow because I'm building out the structure. You know, in art school, you paint a lot of skulls. Oh my goodness. So many skulls.
So many skulls.
And piles of rags. Oh, yeah, they love to give you piles of rags in art school.
What would you do with said piles of rags?
You paint them.
Really?
It's about seeing the values and tones and shapes. Though I think I would have liked to have seen more crumpled up aluminum foil, bottles of glass, you know what I mean? Like more things that made us deal with texture and light and refraction and things like that instead of just
yeah, that makes
very,
sense.
Very lazy piles of things. Rags. And bones. Sometimes parts. Sometimes we get metal parts. I remember getting metal parts once. That was an exciting day. It's like, it's parts.
So, there was a question here.
I'd love to answer a question.
Can you add things to your paint if you wanted to, in this case, let's say you had some cremation remains that you wanted to blend into paint to put into a painting. Is that, is there a way to do that?
Yeah.
There is.
Yeah.
How would you
There's
do that?
An artist in Houston paints entirely with human remains.
That's interesting.
Yeah. Yeah, I have a friend who's an avid art collector, and it's the his partner is a doctor, and that's the one artist that they're not allowed to collect. The doctor's like, mm-mm.
Not that one.
I put my foot down on cadaver art. But yes, in all seriousness, if you're trying to create a remembrance piece, which is what you're talking about would be called.
Yeah.
Really, the trick is you can add that into acrylic paints and into acrylic gels. They will stabilize the remains. They do, and you would not be alone in that. That is actually done much more commonly than you would think and is a very profound action that you can take as an artist. So it's going to create some grit. Right, and it's going to impact it in that way, right? But you can work the softer material, and shockingly, I've had a lot of conversations about this because again, this is a very common practice in art that people do. I'm sure if you Googled it, you'd get a lot of information back. I just don't think people openly talk about that, you know. And it won't impact your paint. Other than you'll have kind of a grit texture, but frankly, I buy grit texture to add to my paint to get that. So, and then, you know, you would seal it and you would do everything, and then that would be in that painting forever. It's actually kind of amazing and magical.
Huh, pretty cool.
Yes. Not at all like the artist I'm referring to in Houston. Who's got another thing going, but a remembrance painting, and that's how you should think of it, and that is a really honorable, long time. This is literally a very old practice in painting. In fact, Mummy Brown was actually named because that pigment was made from mummies. So, really normal, really old practice, a lot of information and material. If you want to message me on Facebook, is this not working?
Why? Is it bad?
No, it keeps getting on the inside of the
thing. Okay, so if you want to message me on Facebook, right, and talk to me about that, and I'm really sorry for your loss. I let's all send. Do we know who asked the question?
Kim did.
Kim, can we all send you love? And we're just very sorry for your loss.
It may.
Yeah. But it's very healing what you're talking about. I have not done that yet in my own practice, but I have known quite a lot of people who have. So if I can help in any way, message me.
Yeah, it looks like there's a couple people out there that appreciate that. They had some interest in doing this for loved ones and was could use the info.
Yeah, that's just it's a thing that's done, and people I'm sure if you Googled it, it's out there, but I just don't think people talk about it. And I think it's such a challenging time. People don't know how to talk about it. And that's really, you know, just my number one thing is know that I will totally help you do that. And it's a very normal, common thing to do. And it's a beautiful thing to do. And it's an uplifting thing to do. And I, from what I've heard, it's a very healing, restoring thing to do. Yeah. So any way that I can help at all. That's a profound question.
Yeah, it was more profound than one would think.
More profound than one would think. More profound than one would think. And now I gotta,
What are you painting with there?
I'm still in a half inch angle brush.
Oh, you like that brush?
I'm just really liking that brush right now because it's a good blocking brush. I'm gonna come back in here and I've got this sort of grayed out little blue with the purple in it. And I'm just gonna create a slightly lighter bag because I just need to work out some lightness here. This is called tonal blocking. Another way that we could do this, which I haven't shown yet, but I'm going to, is to do an umber study where we do an underpainting where we put it all in value shades in umber.
An umber study.
An umber study. Just a value study. Everything is done in umber. And I'm bringing this lighter shade up here. I'm going to take this up over the edge and come around the ocular socket. So I have found we've had a lot of people painting with us through loss, which really awes John and I every time we hear about that, doesn't it,
Sweetie? Yeah, it's just crazy.
It's not crazy.
Well, I mean, for me, it's
Is because many of you guys, I mean, like, we're all having this human experience and we can all relate to each other. And so if somebody writes about a profound loss and how they're painting to get through it, you know, John and I then have to, like, we ask that question, would we be that strong?
Yeah.
You know, we often go to that place where we're like, could we be that strong? And you guys are always thanking us and saying thank you for the lessons. But I have to say thank you for the inspiration because you've really inspired me to know how strong we could be.
Yeah, no kidding.
It's just blown my mind. So I'm coming here and I'm just adding a little of this, some places to just, and you can kind of see now that the skull takes shape real fast.
Yep, real does.
Really fast. So I'm going to put that brush in, rinse it out. And I'm going to start thinking about my roses. So my roses are going to be a little of my cat red and my dog's name purple. And these are not as complicated as the remembrance rose that we did yesterday. Not yesterday, I guess it was Saturday. Ooh, yesterday was a hard day. So what I do is I paint in my outer sort of like what I know my overall rose shape is going to be. So this first rose is sort of a round shape. Right, with this dark, dark color, because again, right, here I've got it painted in. When you work roses, you're working the darkest to the lightest. And then I've got this rose, which is sort of, and I can even, you know, make the outer brush strokes imagining petals coming out. This is a much looser rose than what we did yesterday. Yes, sweetie?
There's a very interesting question that happened all at once. Like everyone asked the same question at once.
Oh, okay.
And it was...
I want to answer that question.
Can you make your own angle brush by cutting another brush? Well, for matter, can you cut your brush?
I am sure that you can, and there's a way to do it. I have never done that in my life, and... what I imagine, I'm making another smaller dark shape down here for this rose down here. This dark little space that I'm going to put this rose. So here's the thing. Precision tools are used to create brushes. An angle brush, an angle shader is a very common brush. So what I would really say is like, you know, try to find it if you can. If you just are wanting to have the experience where you make a brush, I mean, artists used to make their own brushes, so clearly you can make a brush because artists used to make their own brushes. So I hope you guys are seeing this sort of like little red shape that I'm doing here. And these are just, can we see this on the up close cam?
By the way.
Move it a little bit.
Or you move the canvas either way.
Nausea cam.
There you go.
Yeah. So they're just sort of like not quite perfectly round shapes. And I know I've got a petal coming off here. And the reason I can be so very relaxed about the shape of these flowers, guys, is that I'm going to be putting in dark leaves, and this is such a dark painting, and so I can be very... If you go to David Jensen, you can see a lot of how to paint rose wet into wet. So cutting brushes. Google that one, YouTube that one. There's probably somebody out there who's like in some weird Renaissance art journey. There's a lot of art journeys. There is an art school. They don't let you draw or paint for years, and you have to do all this apprenticeship, and you make your art materials, and you got to dig stuff out of the earth, and you got to dissect a horse, and then you rebuild the horse layer by layer. It's a Russian school. Layer by layer by layer, and you come out of it a master recreated Russian amazing painter. And there's a really good one in Italy, and these are these intense education programs. I heard about them from Daniel Elliott, right down to sort of a West Coast, we're gonna blow some glass, man. That's gonna be groovy. Kind of, there's a lot of journey. Huh. The full spectrum in art. So somewhere, somebody is jumping their neighbor's fences and stealing horse hair and hog's hair and tying their own brushes, and will probably share with you how they did it.
If you really want to know.
If you really want to know.
But generally, Jerry's runs pretty good sales on brushes.
Yeah, and I'm not paid by them. Jerry didn't even acknowledge me. I'm just saying Jerry's got an angle brush for cheap.
Yep.
Work.
You can cut them.
Just have, I mean, that hole.
The worst thing is you're going to have a scrumbly brush at the end of it.
Worst thing is you're going to have a scrumbly brush. I have not done that in my art practice. Haven't done it. I'm going to switch brushes.
What brush are you going to switch to?
I'm going to get myself a nice bright.
Ooh.
Nice half-inch bright. Shall I hold up my little thing? Do-do-do-do-do.
It's a little smaller than a half-inch.
Am I trying out for QVC?
I think it works. I think you've proven it works.
I proved myself to QVC. You guys, I'm just being silly. We will never change the format of the show, ever, 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 so you never have to worry.
Until we change the format of the show.
But you know what I mean, like, where we are, like, paid by some sponsor to say something we don't mean. That's
right.
Not happening.
No.
So I'm taking a little of this purple over to my red. I'm going to add a little bit of white to it. Just a little bit. Right? And now I'm going to come up here, and here's what I'm going to do. Let's see, do I have the up close cam on it as good as I can? Yeah, okay. So here's the deal. I'm on the edge of my brush, and I'm going to make a very small stroke right there. And then I'm going to come next to it, pressing down, and then arcing around lightly.
Yeah, it's real hard to see it there.
Can you
actually
see
I can see it from the higher camera angle better. Almost.
Okay, well, that's crazy. All
it's
right.
Just because your hand's in the way of the brush stroke.
So I'm going to come here, and I'm going to bring this around. And I try to make these shapes very uneven. This is really the trick of roses. It's just, they're not sensible. They're just hot messes. Just hot messes, these flowers. Wonderful, beautiful hot messes like people. Wonderful, beautiful hot messes like people. You know, you just got to... You know, just got to go for it. This is one of those things, like, the more you do it, the easier it gets. We've done this. We did this kind of style of rose on the Dies de los Muertos, the sugar skull, that I did in that collaboration with Ayala. So I'm here saying there's a little outer petal, and it just starts to come in. Right? I know it feels like it's like, what's happening? It's so magical. No, it's just, your eye just knows roses do this, and then it goes, rose, rose. What's really happening when you're painting your brain is that you're painting something, and then your brain goes, oh, I know, I know, I know, I know. It's a rose. Let me finish all the part of the picture for you. Rose. It likes to guess. It's what your brain is like literally designed to do, is to guess. So I'm back here. On the up-close camera, whichever cam you think.
Yeah, the up-close cam, your hand's in the way. It just happens to be. But from the up top, see, put your hand up there.
I think,
see,
like,
goes,
go back and forth so that people can see
oh,
it.
Oh, I do.
Okay. I'm not backseat editing, sweetheart.
Of course you are.
I'm not. I'm just trying to say, see, I mean, that kind of crazy little shape there.
We need all the editing help we can get.
And if you dig the remembrance rose, you can kind of see that that's a very different rose than what we're doing here. How we did that totally different process. And I'm going to add this little petal here because I'm feeling it. So you can see how the dark shadow with the higher highlight then starts to pull that out. Now I'm going to take a little, I'm going to rinse this out a little bit like you do. I'm going to come over and I'm going to get some yellow.
We've got about 60 people in here with us.
60!
Isn't that great?
That's mind-blowing.
And we wanted to...
Mind-blowing.
And you know, I want to thank everyone for showing up. And of course, you know, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.
Well, now there's John.
That's me.
That's John. Like, comment, and subscribe because YouTube likes it. But they actually really do.
They do. You know, it does let YouTube know that you're here and that you like what we're doing. And then it tells YouTube that we should be doing more of it. And then it's all...
And then YouTube shows us to more people who might want to paint.
And then there's a bigger audience.
You know? They're two friends, and they're two friends, and they're two friends. And pretty soon we're a big party on the beach.
And see, what I like is that we start getting pictures of people's stuff.
Oh, I love that. You guys, all the mermaids have been bananas good. All of the Eiffel Towers have been loving it. All of the sugar skulls, you guys have been blown. Somebody combined a sugar skull with a galaxy.
Yeah.
They're like, mash up.
Yeah, we
blown away.
And when you're ready, we've got a couple pictures queued up from
oh, I would show. Here, I'm going to put some highlights.
Yeah, just whenever you're ready.
Okay, after we'll put some highlights in and let's show some pictures.
Okay, cool.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come out here on the outer edge of all my petals. I'm not going to work that inner edge because I want to save that color. And I'm going to pull this in just a little bit. Okay, just a little bit. This is where the highlight gets caught. And I can hold it up to the camera if I need to. Pulling this in. And by having the paint just lit at the tip of my brush, that helps me do that. The fact that some of this is wet helps me. And if I need to come and reload just the tip, I go smudge, smudge, and then I do that. I'm gonna come in here, adding just a little bit of this. It's just so, you could just do a whole canvas of just this. You just fill up a whole canvas with roses.
Just roses away.
You're painting a 16 by 20, got a bunch of empty space over here. If you felt really good putting these roses, you could put a big clump of them in over there. You could just rose up. Like Barney from How I Met Your Mother suits up, you could rose up.
That's right.
You're like, I'm rosing up. What are you doing today? I'm rosing up. See how we're doing that? Look at that. So that is coming in more, 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 more.
Ooh, those layers, those really help.
So all I do is get a lot more white on that color. Guys, that's all I'm going to do. And guess what? I'm going to come put that a couple places. Like I'm going to come up along this petal and pull this out right here, just along this one petal. And I'm going to pick a little spot along this one where I follow along. Because that highlight wouldn't be everywhere. I want to pick it up some places, though. Picking it up right here. There a little bit. Maybe on that inner edge there. Pick it up hard there. Oh, look at that. That petal just pulled out, didn't it?
Yep.
It just all of a sudden, petal! I am petal. There you go. And so there's that rose.
That looks really good.
See, that is the joy of that, is just literally, and you can keep building that up, and you can keep going in and adding dark if you want to.
Yeah.
You can keep getting in there and working that out. There's no end. It's just a little rose story that you're telling. And this is that first real simple rose story that you're telling. And then when you feel good about this, you can come in and do remembrance rose and be like, I'm so rosed up. And we'll talk about roses and flowers a lot because those are a good object to think. Can we share some of the artwork? I'm gonna sippy sippy.
We can. Yeah, sippy sippy. So I think that the first thing I had was a cool mug that you wanted to share.
Yes.
Let me see if
From
I can
somebody who's Buffy. Did I geek out? I'll
bring it up here.
Did I? Buffy's mug? Did I?
Yep, that's it. And somebody said that we should have this as a sippy today. What do you think?
I think.
And then
I already had this, and so I was like, okay.
It's pretty cool. Then we had a koi fish.
This was Mona's koi.
Oh, that's right.
So I wanted to show off. Everybody knows Mona. Mona's moderating today. This is Mona's koi, and I just thought she did a really good job. You guys are really blowing my mind with the koi.
That was really cool. And then we also had a couple.
Yeah, this one. So this is a remembrance painting. This lady shared an amazing story with me. Sandy is one of those artists that she comes in, she tells me her art story, and I am just in awe of her. She's going through loss, so let's all send Sandy a lot of love. And it's a rough one, but she's painting, and she's putting that into the art, and she feels connected when she's doing that. And I just have no words for how much your open-heartedness, like, amazed me. If you live open-hearted, you will never be lost. Wow, you prove that.
Yeah.
And you have my respect and my love, and thank you for sharing your art story with me. That was really profound. So when you guys look at that painting, man, really feel that, because that was in there.
Yep.
Just blew my mind. All right, let's get the rest of these roses in, though, while we're pondering that.
Yeah.
You know, because I painted through bullying in school, right? When I got bullied in school, and I painted through, you know, being upset or angsty and stuff, or very sad, or, you know, those kinds of things. But I have not had to challenge myself that level.
Yeah.
By any means. So I'm going to come here, and I'm going to just tip of my brush, start putting in those little petals that come concentrically around. This rose is a little bit in perspective.
Oh, yeah?
Yep. Instead of three-quarter view. I only did one of them on this one, but we'll work harder on that concept on another one. All right. Sometimes you just want to build up some concepts, and then you just...
Yeah.
You know.
I'm going to bring the colors back up there for them next time you're over there, just
okay,
so that those...
Okay, I'm putting this right here. You know what I'm realizing just now?
What's that?
And you're going to laugh. The first one I did was a 12 by 12, and this is a 10 by 10, and I'm like, why is this not dimensionally the exact same? Oh, well, different size canvas.
There it goes.
Different size
canvas.
People
can see what our colors
Sherpa
are.
Oh, isn't it? I love that palette today. Pretty palette.
Oh, where'd it go?
Now I'm going to bring this little petal out in this kind of crazy shape right here. I want a crazy shape petal.
Got all sorts of crazy stuff happening.
And I'm going to pull out another crazy shape petal right here. Like that. And that's what you're looking for, is what can I pull out? What can I put in? And again, we're going to have a traceable. You can look. Now the roses in Mark's photograph were much more complicated.
Yes.
Than this. This is a way of talking about these objects and simplifying them so that we can enjoy them. So that rose is open. And we can already see that space is half. Look at that just come in. It just comes in. Painting, just you give to painting and painting gives back. Chuck shared that with me. If you live open-hearted, you'll never be lost. Isn't that wonderful?
Yeah.
I really like it. I think it needs to be a shirt. That's what I said. Chuck, make sure. We need a shirt that says that. I would wear that everywhere. Just everywhere.
Yeah.
I'd be like up at the art leagues going, if you lived open-hearted, you'd never be lost. Right there in my shirt. We've got some exciting stuff coming up this week.
Do we?
Yeah.
What's
you know that?
That
we do. What do you mean, do we? Do you not live here?
I don't. I don't know what's going on. I just push buttons.
What? Didn't you get the memo?
I didn't push
it. See the whiteboard?
It didn't make it on my Google calendar.
It didn't make it on. Well, we have Creator Day.
Oh, yeah. Creator Day.
And I've got Ian and Todd coming down to visit.
Oh, yeah. Ian and Todd.
So Off Kilter Crafter and Todd Graham. And I think if everyone doesn't mind, I'm planning on having them in the studio to goof with us.
That'd be awesome.
I thought they should come by and be goofy with us. So pull some color out of what you had and add some white. We're going to start lightening this flower up. All right. So are we okay painting a little smaller today, guys?
Everyone seems to be...
Is that okay? Not going to be doing it all the time. Mostly going to always stay 16 by 20 because that's just easy and cheap.
Yep. It's a nice canvas.
Yeah, it's a nice canvas and, you know, works for people. But take that light. Now I'm really see what I'm doing here. I'm preserving the shadow. I'm preserving the shadow. That seems like the beginning of a really bad vampire novel for teenagers. I don't want to start a war with anybody, but ooh, Twilight. I barely survived that series of movies. Oh my goodness. Team none of this. That's the team I was on. But I'm a completionist. John opted out after the first movie, but I'm a completionist, so I had to watch the whole thing.
Yep.
While he mocked me from the other room. What are you doing? I'm finishing Twilight.
We're having I have to say that out here in the comments, there's quite a lively chat going on.
What are they saying?
Oh, they're right now. Everyone's comparing birth dates, and I have to say we have a very, very diverse crowd out there today.
Really?
Yeah, it's pretty awesome. So
I like that everybody is very much there for each other.
Oh yeah.
I really like that about, I love the DIY on YouTube. I certainly am not trying to start a war with other like YouTube sectors. I'm just saying, I think the DIY space on YouTube is the best. Hey, did Kathy Bauer come today?
You know, I'll have to take a look out here for her. I've seen a couple Kathys.
So if she did, I just want to say hi and make sure she's feeling good today.
I'll keep an eye out over here.
Yeah, you know, some of you guys have painted with me a long, long time. Like from Frog Hat Day. I always like go by the hat. What hat did you start
on? Hat?
Frog Hat be day one. What you don't know is, John, you remember that first painting that we did where you just kept filming it and painting it and filming
yes.
it and painting it? And I was like, I'm never ever going to paint this painting again because you just... We never got the video up, and it was like, and I was like, I can't feel. So somebody found in my pictures that painting and liked it, and then boom, it was up to 100 likes, and all these people were like, hey, what are you teaching this one? I was like, no! How did they find it? Because it was like way back in early Facebook days. They found it. So I have a very light color here, and I'm going to start creating this right here. Just adding this very light color. Just some places. How do you guys like these roses? You enjoying these simple, happy roses?
People seem to be loving it out there.
Look at that little highlight there.
It's looking really good. I'm going to zoom in there.
Little bud happening.
Yeah.
Little buds.
Yeah, we've got like, so from 16 to 64 today.
16 to 64.
Yeah. It's
we rock. We exist in a way YouTube has told us we cannot.
Yep, we have definitely crossed some demographic.
Well, first of all, YouTube says no one but 13-year-olds watches YouTube.
It's full of cats and little girls.
Cats and little girls, which it is. I'm not denying that. I mean, I'm here, but...
But that's not the only thing on YouTube.
That's not. I'm like, I'm pretty sure I know grown-ups on YouTube, and I know painters and 16-year-olds and all kinds of different people. Putting that in there. Just adding those little highlights. How do we feel about that?
Ooh.
And we can come in with a little yellow. I like to come in with sometimes with a little yellow and add a little bit of extra here and there. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. It does add a little bit more.
It does. You know what's amazing? More is more. It's so... It shouldn't be. Shouldn't work out like that. Just a little bit happening here.
Yeah.
So, That was, I know, a little bit slow, but hey, fun. We're going to switch to, what brush should we switch to?
What brush?
I don't know. It's like not quite an inch filbert. Let's show the QVC. QVC.
Yeah.
Home Shopping Network. I'm not trying to alienate anybody.
So if you go down, we can do the close-up.
I can be like Joan Rivers. I can do it.
You can also use a close-up camera for that, too.
I could actually use it. See, that's why I'm not getting picked up.
We gotta keep practicing more.
You guys
live
should
shows.
Know though that my mom's been on which one was she on? Was it QVC or Home Shopping?
I don't know. One of them.
Yeah, I'm gonna add a little yellow ochre to this. A little darker blue. I'm just trying to find the green I'm looking for. So I'm gonna come here and I'm going to add just a couple little spots in this brighter green. I'm gonna have to come back with something darker because I feel like this is just too light. Let me just get some yellow ochre and some phthalo. That's a little bit more. Come here, I'm gonna add some emotive blue. Oh, I will show it, it's kind of painterly. We're just gonna come in here. We need to pick up some burnt sienna and put it in there, you do that. Don't forget to paint your edges when you're doing these canvases.
Oh yeah.
And I'm gonna show you real quick. It makes a difference. Like I've got a paint down here. I forgot down here. So see, that's what it is. And then everyone can see down here and they'll be like, what? And you're like, ugh. And of course I dropped my rag. And now my hat. It's all good.
You're right, we got it on video.
Only good for mocking, but not good for any other thing.
It'll be great when I get the instant replay.
You're so much fun, aren't you?
Well, see, yes, I like pushing buttons, and I need buttons
just
with special effects.
Making sure that this has something underneath, because you'll really want something underneath there. You will. You really, really, really will. Well, and you can come in with a little dioxine purple and a little yellow ochre and a little white. And you can work in here too. Just trying to pull this out.
You know, we've had off and on a little over 60 people painting with
us
today.
How are they feeling about today's painting?
Pretty good. And you know, I have to say, you know, Mona said thank you because she always feels better when she paints with us. And I have to say, we always feel better when we have you guys painting with us. Because this wouldn't be any fun without you guys.
Well, I mean, I was having fun. It is a more interesting journey now that I'm sharing it with friends. If you need to come back in and darken some of this up.
You want to adjust the close-up camera there too?
Sure.
Just so we can pull that up a little bit. There you go.
Go ahead and do that because this may need a little deepening. Right? Because sometimes when I'm painting on with Periscope, I will get into different colors and I will play a little bit. But I really don't want to ever make you guys have to go on too big of a shop. Every once in a while, I'll have you guys get something new. But mostly, I try not to make you guys go shopping. Try to prevent that from happening to you. Just put this back in. Just trying to give this some interest as well. That's what I'm constantly looking for is, like, is it too much hole? Is it not enough hole? But I think we've got some stuff there. Let's get that skull in.
Oh, yeah. I think that'll look good.
Fun to put in the skull. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to deepen. And if I need to, now I might get a little of that black, just a little bit. I really want to darken this right here. This ocular space, I want to start darkening it. Can you see that up on the up close cam or the side cam?
Yeah, well, we can see it as you're painting it in there.
Right, and we're going to even get into the, you know me, I'm generally never in the black, but I'm going to get in here a little bit, work that in. And then while it's still wet, and you're like, wait, what are you doing? I'm going to get just a small amount of white. very lightly create just a little bit of light in here. It's an important thing. Wipe my brush off. And I'm going to get my little purple and even maybe a little of my black. And I'm going to really get dark inside this nasal cavity. Now, I'm not like Temperance Brennan, and I may have done like bones. You know, like, I think we have a detective that paints with us, and she might be like, I don't even think that skull's too many genders. She might be watching us going, I would be surprised if she did this painting, because I think she likes to like, in her off time, get into happier work. She likes her off time artwork to be a little more cheerful.
Yeah.
But, so I'm working this down the side a little bit, deepening that up.
Now, the color palette that we're using today is pretty much your basic color palette, right?
I try to use it's not my full basic color palette. You know, I get into more colors than this in my own studio.
Yeah.
But what I try to do is create a standard color palette, especially with students. I really hate it when art teachers have crazy colors and there's like a gazillion of them, and people on a budget have to go buy a bunch of stuff. I think it's like, come on, you just really, once you have red, you know,
Southern
blue
Ocean
and yellow
blue.
And yeah, you just don't need so many crazy paints.
Like Southern Ocean Blue?
I learned, yeah. And that's not that much.
No. Well, which one, it's like,
but I was like, when people started saying, I'm having trouble getting Southern Ocean Blue, I was like, cut.
Yep.
Not using it in the studio anymore for classes. We might eventually get stuff where we get into like, you know, some tubes of paint in acrylic can be like $70. The CAD is the only thing that I really put you guys into, and that's because you can opt out into hue.
Yep,
for a
true.
More economically reasonable experience. Though we were talking about a cool project, weren't we, John, about getting in there and do the painting for under 20?
Oh, yeah.
Try to see.
Just go to Walmart, get the cheapest set we could, and see what it would take. Just like go in there, like, can we paint for like $20 or $30?
Can
like,
we? What can we do? We were going to try and do that.
Just like going to Walmart with $20, say, can I buy a basic set of acrylics, a basic set of brushes,
and then show you how I would handle those materials, like what my tips and tricks would be.
Yeah, just shotgun it. But we'll switch over there next time I'm on the palette cam, and I'll pull up the graphic, and they can, you know, just so that people will have that to note down what our.
So I think he's kind of getting skullacular.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Right? So I'm going to come here, I'm going to get a little purple and a little blue on my brush. I said that backwards. I'm going to add some white, and I'm going to get back over here because I want a lighter color. And right here, I'm going to start lightening things up. Maybe get some burnt. What it is, the lights are gumming up my paint.
Oh, are they? That mm-hmm. light, the light we added over there is making
no,
it.
No, I don't know what's happening, but the paint is just drying and gumming on me in about 2 seconds, and so I'm really having to, like, work around it.
Well, if we need to turn that little light
off. Okay. I don't think it's that little light. I think it's just that the studio is hot today.
Huh.
I'm going to, what I could start doing is having a mister in here. So I'm trying to create a lighter plane here.
Yeah.
I'm coming along this ocular cavity and pulling this out a little bit. Then in here. Over here, just a little bit up here. All right, and this is sort of that grayed out blue. I'm gonna come up here. And then there's a sort of triangle of lightness over the nose. I'm gonna get some just purple. While my not even rinsing out my brush, and come here on the inside though. Interesting thing, I'm gonna work right there. And I'm gonna get a little, it's quite a dark color, I'm gonna get a little white, got my purple, I'm gonna do something crazy. I'm gonna come here now.
You may wanna grab that close up camera there.
Yeah, move it down. Yeah. Teeth are important.
A little further. So we can see the teeth there a little better. A little matte bottom. There we go.
And it's still a nausea cam. I'm going to get a little more brown into this. Purple.
Wouldn't be any fun without it.
So I'm still working my The teeth are whiter at the bottom than they are at the top. I don't paint them all in. I know I encourage you guys to do that a lot. And I'm gonna leave a gap here. I feel like we need to have a broken tooth. And like slightly bigger teeth. And so I sort of just put those in. And I even want those darker than I painted them in. I want them kind of brown and coming back with some brown, knocking them. Just working that back. If you get the teeth too large, you can always come in with a dark, dark, dark color. Break them, trim them. You could say that tooth has a little break in it. You know, don't feel like you can't come back with a dark color and be like, oh, you're just a broken tooth. I don't even have to listen to you. And trim the size of your teeth. Totally do that. See that? See that? Those are very adjustable elements. I'm going to get some blue, I got some brown on there, and some white.
It's looking pretty good.
I'm going to add some highlights here. Interestingly enough, there's some stuff that comes up into the nose.
Every once in a while we get a...
Around here you have a highlight. Every once in a while we get a what?
We get a question about who's that creepy voice in the background.
Really? Do they say creepy? Because you always say creepy. Are they saying creepy? I feel like it's just you saying creepy.
I don't know if they said creepy this time. I'll go look.
Did someone ever say creepy?
I don't know. I've not been keeping track.
Mm-hmm. You're so weird.
It says, who is the talking guy?
The talking guy is my husband, John, and he's been conscripted into my world.
Yeah. No, they.
This is the ultimate honeydew. Hey, honey. I'd like to have a YouTube show.
Could you help me set up my cameras? Dot, dot, dot.
It won't be any trouble. Oh, it's so funny. It's coming up here. So I don't know, is this a good Halloween one? See, I've just put a little dab of paint there. What I'm doing is I'm creating, when I painted this, when I looked at the original photograph I was looking at, see if I can show you. Ooh, this isn't his photograph, but you can really see when you print out skulls, these sort of like planar shapes and the things that you're looking for. And so you can always print out a skull or something to get inspiration from. And if you haven't painted 100 skulls in your life, you might need some help painting a skull in the form of a picture.
Yeah, doesn't hurt at all.
You know, there are some people who painted so many skulls, they're like, I don't even need a picture, just put it right here. A forensic artist would be one. A forensic artist would definitely be one of those people. I'm going to come here with a very light highlight around this outer eye.
I'm actually curious now to hear.
I'm putting one right here.
Oh, that looks so nice. I like how the shape of the skull just pops in that way.
Yeah, it just, it's crazy how fast. I'm going to put a highlight right here.
Looks good. So, I'm actually kind of curious.
You might need to go see Spider.
Oh, is he here? I'll go check
on
him.
He's having a hard time.
I'll go check on him real quick.
Yeah. I hear him really struggling. We have sitting, but, you know. Kids are kids. You didn't get to see that. I just got some more white. I must work that right here. Yeah. Sometimes we get boo-boos. I'm going to come along this outer nasal edge here and bring it around. If we miss questions that you guys are posting right now, I'm sorry. I'm going to add a little highlight right there. Maybe another little one right here on this cheekbone. I'm trying to define this out. Now, I'm going to get down into this area. I'm going to get a little yellow ochre. I think I want a little yellow on this stroke. So I'm adding yellow ochre. You're not seeing it, but I'm adding a little yellow ochre. I'll let John come back in.
Okay.
I'm going to show him. We're adding a little yellow ochre.
Okay. I'm
is he okay?
Yeah. No,
we may have a little more din in the background, which we will accept because the kids are going to have some friends over.
Oh.
That's all it was.
Okay. So
there was, you know, We just had a
coming along here. I'm just going to add some highlights in this. And I want to come and get some purple. It's interesting. A lot of times I won't rinse my brush. I will just get a color and let things happen on the canvas. I'm really weird like that. But that's something a lot of artists do, where I won't rinse my brush and I'll pick up a darker color and let the lighter color and it all sort of mixes out here. And then I'm like darkening it.
That looks really cool when you pick up that.
Yeah, it makes me super happy. I'm just going to grab some yellow ochre and I'm going to come in here. Now, interesting, I'm going to come to this outer edge of the teeth with just this yellow ochre. I haven't rinsed my brush. And I'm going to start just highlighting part of the teeth.
Wow, yeah. And those layers just keep building depth
on there. They just keep building depth. If I paint the top of the canvas.
Hey, you have to roll it. Right, you go.
Did it roll up or where did it go?
Yeah, I got it.
All right. So I'm just going to add some of this yellow ochre because we're trying to show, you know, what's going on. I'm going to put a little bit maybe in that eye right there.
Oh, yeah. Just a little.
Isn't that cool? So cool. Now I'm going to get a bright, bright white. And I haven't rinsed my brush, though, so it won't be a pure white, which is sort of an interesting thing. Another one here. I'm going to come here and just right there, along there. I'm going to work this outer right there. And then I'm going to create a little triangle of highlight right here. Triangle of highlight.
Oh, yeah, that looks really nice.
A little bit here, and then right here. Triangle of highlight. Right there. And take this, it's not a white because I've let the brush be dirty.
Yep.
And I'm going to work just a little bit of the tooth again. Just highlighting that shape. So now we have these sort of scully, crackly little teeth, right?
Yeah.
Which is super enjoyable. And here's what I think is really important to do.
You rinse your brush there.
I rinse my brush there because I'm going to take a little yellow. I'm going to come over to my CAD. Get a little white in here. And I'm going to get a peach like what I used on my roses. And I'm going to add some peach to my skull. And that is a very important thing to do in painting.
Why is that?
When you pull a color through a composition like this, right? You create this. We're going to come on this side where the flowers are and reflect it. We're going to reflect some here, like the flowers are reflecting onto this skull. And it pulls it compositionally together in a way that I'm going to add some of that peach in the eye.
That looks pretty awesome.
And that is essentially, and you can keep working this background. Like if you're like, oh, I gotta get some more work on that background. You can keep working that. If you want to come in here and be like, you know, I need to, you know, come along here. I just made this little kind of little crazy green and create. What you're going to look for is you're just finding your way through composition. That is how you do that skull. That's how you get through that. I'm going to hold
that
up for you.
Amazing. Yeah. Really turned out cool. And that you can show the edges were so painted so they can see that you painted all around the corners. And that really makes that nice finished look.
And you guys will be like, well, you know, sometimes when you do original paintings and you're doing them on Periscope or you show after you're working through stuff, I might have multi-hours in a piece that I put into it. I might come to it and look at it or have a photograph reference or come back and see something. Always feel like you can work in your piece as long as you need to work it out. I think that's an important thing in, you know, in an art journey is like, looking into a piece and saying, hey, I want to go back in and add some darkness, or I want to go sharpen an edge, or I want to work a color. Just do that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Josh.
Yeah. I don't know. How was...
Whoa.
I'm hatless.
Your hat.
Just, you know, there's no reason for the hat. It's just, I like them. I like, did you think Margaret did a good job on this? Because I feel like she did.
Yeah,
I feel
that's
like
a great
queen.
Hat. That's a really great hat.
I feel like
hat.
A skull queen. I feel really special today with Margaret's headpiece on. She's so talented.
Yep. And it was, and I have to say thank you to all of our moderators who hung in with us today. Thank you so much for showing up.
Anybody have any questions before we go?
You know, we didn't, everyone is sending lots of love and encouragement to both, you know, Mona, who's getting over her little bug there. And
I think I said something to you on the Facebook page. Yeah. We got so much get well.
Yeah.
I didn't want to be like, oh, my husband has Crohn's and it's a Crohn's day. And it just sort of takes us all out. And then the kids get kind of under the weather and everybody just gets a little bit down. And you guys, the love was incredible.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
I was like really, really thrilled because I didn't know if it was going to be like, hey, let's get some whole week around this. What are you doing?
Yeah.
Everybody was super nice. And that's been really true on our channel here, is everybody's really nice.
Yeah.
We feel really lucky about that. And I hope you guys, I hope the skull episode was in no way a letdown.
It's been pretty happy. I think I was happy. I love it. Everyone else out here seems to love it. The good sippy sippies.
Oh,
we've had a great time.
You guys gave me an excuse where I had to get this. Or, I mean, I had to, right?
Yeah.
Because, you know, show, had to do it. Had to give myself permission.
Yep. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe before you leave.
Tell your friends. Get them painting.
Yep.
You know, if you guys, I know I've got,
yeah.
Weeping Angel coming
Weeping
up.
Weeping Angel.
Definitely, probably, because of so many suggestions, going to do some sort of witches in cauldron kind of thing for the fall CAC event.
Yep. That sounds
you guys
fun.
Asked, and I believe for sure you can count on a zombie.
Ooh.
A zombie coming up.
Zombies would be good. I think someone was requesting squirrels and chipmunks, too.
So dude, I will squirrel and chipmunk up.
We'll have to think about that.
Oh, somebody else made a really cool request where a week of barnyard animals, where every day we just go online, like pig, chicken, cow.
I'm in. I think that'd be fun. We just got to schedule a week where I know I'm in town, and we're just going to do, like, you know, old...
Animal Farm Week, but with a happy ending.
Old McCooney had a farm.
Old McCooney had a farm. We're so goofy, yo.
All right.
I want to see you guys at the easel really soon. Remember, live open-hearted. You'll never be lost. Anybody that wants to follow up with me on some of the questions that we were talking about, I will try to get that information for you. And remember, remembrance painting is a happy, normal, healthy thing to do, and I think it's beautiful, and I commend you for expressing yourself in that way. That's incredible. Bye-bye.